We're going to learn about division, specifically dividing fractions by whole numbers. I'm going to show you two ways. The first way math teachers tend to use. The second way helps you understand why math teachers use the first way. Our example problem is 1/2 divided by 3. What are we going to do? Notice this first number is a fraction. We're going to have to change this 3 to a fraction before we can continue. This 3 equals 3 over 1. Well, why is that? How do we know that 3 over 1 equals 3? 3 over 1 means 3 divided by 1. 1 times what number here will equal 3? Let's think about this one. Let's try 1. 1 times 1. 1 times 1 equals 1. Can't do that. Why? Because 1 is smaller than 3. Next, 1 times 2. 1 times 2 equals 2. We can't use that one either, because 2 is smaller than 3. Next, 1 times 3. Yes, we can. 1 times 3 equals 3. Next, we multiply 1 times 3, and that equals 3. Now what are we going to do? Subtract. (3 − 3) = 0. Now, we know that 3 over 1 equals 3 divided by 1, which equals 3. Next, what are we going to do? This 1/2, we're going to bring it right down here. Division becomes multiplication. And this 3 over 1, we flip it. Now, 1 times 1 equals 1. (2 × 3) = 6. 1/6. Many people see this process and they can't understand it. They become confused. This division sign becomes multiplication. Why? This 3 over 1 flips and becomes 1/3. Well, why does that happen? Well, now we're going to solve the same problem using the second way, using pictures. Suppose you have a friend and the two of you bake a pizza. You and your friend split the pizza in half. This 1/2 represents the amount of pizza your friend has. Your friend's not hungry. He only wants to eat 1/3 of his pizza. So what does your friend do? He takes his pizza and he splits it into 3 equally sized pieces. 1, 2, 3. Dividing by 3 means separating the pizza into 3 slices that are all the same size. Your friend eats 1 slice. Right there. Where do you put the 1? Right there. In the numerator. How many slices equal 1 whole pizza? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Where do you put the 6? Right there, in the denominator. The answer is 1/6. And we're finished. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Now, watch more math videos.